Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of The Circle Pit. We are here with episode 18. Wow, that's crazy. 18 episodes. So, thank you all for tuning in. First off, we're going to start with an album review. And if you don't know what that album review is, you should start paying a little more attention to the social medias, okay? We're going to start with the new Ghost album, Prequelle. So overall, there are 12 songs on the album, but that's only the deluxe version. The original version of the album only has 10 songs, and that has Ashes, Rats, Faith, See the Light, Miasma, Dance Macabre, Pro Memoria, Witch Image, Helvetis Fonster, and Life Eternal. Okay, so now I waited up until midnight for this album, just so I can give you guys a nice album review. Now, if you've seen them on the tour, they open with Ashes and Rats. Ashes is a creepy, creepy song, and I just, it's really, I don't know, it's just, here, listen to this real quick. Now, they opened the concert with that song, and it's a whole thing. It goes on for 48 seconds. A minute and 48 seconds. So it's pretty long, and then it cuts right into the Rats that we all know and love. Now, overall, the album's really good, and I personally love it. Like, it's going to take a couple listens to, like, finally get to, like, where it is. I personally love Opus Eponymous the best. But, this album is going to be great. It's already number one on the album chart for iTunes. So, Ashes and Rats, great combination. Then it goes into Faith. Faith is a really heavy song. And it's just amazing. See the Light is kind of like a slower, mellowed down song compared to Faith. Like, if you're not into, like, the heavier stuff, See the Light is more for you. Miasma is a instrumental song, and if you went to see them on tour, that is the instrumental song where Papa Nil comes out and does a nice little sax solo. Then Dance Macabre, we all know. Pro Memoria is a nice little slowed down song about Lucifer. Witch Image is a pretty good song. Helvetis Fonster is another instrumental. And Life Eternal is a nice little slowed down, mellowed. I know I said this already, but like mellowed, slowed down, and just, it's very calm. To like, it's a nice little exit to the album, if you say. Overall, it's a great album. I loved it. And it's just, wow. The album is fantastic. They really put their hard work into this. And yeah. So there's my review of Prequelle. So, for all of you listening to this, make sure you comment on the video and let me know if you guys listened to the new album yet. June 1st is here, and Prequelle is here. So, definitely go check it out and let me know what you guys think. Alright, now continuing on with new music. Hollywood Undead, the metal band from Los Angeles, California, released a new song, also at midnight, with Gotta Let Go. And the lead singer, Johnny Three Tears, said in a tweet, "At times when we look at the past, We only see the struggles and the hardships. We too often forget about the good moments because we are blinded by the pain we all go through. This song is about letting go of that pain so we can see that life can be a beautiful experience. Quote Johnny Three Tears. So yeah, that it's a great song, and it's very nice. And it's just, it's different if you're going from Ghost to Hollywood Undead. Like, I listened to it right after, I listened to the song right after I finished listening to Prequelle, and it was just completely different. So be sure you're aware of that, and let me know what's your opinion on that song, because it's very nice. It was a very nice song. And hopefully this means new music for Hollywood Undead coming soon. I'll be seeing them at Impact Festival, like I said, last week, and on July 27th, sorry. So yeah. And that's really it for new music today. But now we're going to go into some news that either you guys heard of it or not, but first up is I want to talk about the dude that got kicked out of a Slayer show last week or a few days ago and eventually just tried swimming back into the concert. A guy was kicked out of the Slayer show in, Toronto, Ontario, Canada. And he was at the Budweiser stage. It was May 29th. And he got kicked out for unknown reasons. And in order to watch Slayer, Anthrax, Behemoth, and Lamb of God, he decided to swim back into the concert venue. And there's a picture of him posted on Facebook of there's a life preserver right next to him, and this guy's just in the water with an Anthrax shirt on. That would be me. I would be doing that. Props to that guy, because who wouldn't want to miss Slayer on their final tour, you know? Why he got kicked out of the show, I'm not 100% sure, but hopefully it was for a good reason and not for a stupid reason, like most things are today. Next on the list, we got the Summer Slaughter Tour, which is very disappointing. The Summer Slaughter Tour announced all their dates originally, and now they have also announced the headlining bands with all the other little bands. So, to headline the show, it's Between the Buried and Me, Born of Osiris, and Veil of Maya. And to open for all these bands is Entheos, Sorruption, Terror Universal, Allegaeon, The Agony Scene, and Era. So the dates run from July 13th all the way to August 19th. But it also says that there's more dates to be announced, so that's interesting. But all of you people interested in the tri-state area, Baltimore, Maryland, on July 18th at the Baltimore Soundstage. New York City, on July 19th at Irving Plaza. Sayreville, New Jersey, on July 20th at the Starland Ballroom. Worcester, Massachusetts, on July 21st at the Palladium. And Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, on July 22nd at the Theater of Living Arts. Make sure you check them out if you're interested in any of those bands. I myself am not interested because it's very lame. But I don't know. Like it's I'm sure it's gonna be heavy as hell, but I just compared to other Summer Slaughters that they've had, this is by far the weakest that they've had. Like I think last year was like Arch Enemy or Cannibal Corpse, one of those. Carnifex was on it, Thy Art Is Murder. And it's just, come on. How are you going to have all of that and then this? So, it's interesting. Now, I'm not going to go into the horror pit with all the music and everything, only for this one reason. Not a lot of horror stuff this week. But I am continuing to be updated with new horror news every day, so I will keep you all updated. And if possible, if needed, I will make another show for Just Horror during the week next week, if anything comes up. But for right now, the only thing for horror is that June 8th, next Friday, is the movie Hereditary. Now, I talked about this a couple weeks ago, and I think everyone needs to go see this movie because it just looks creepy. And I've seen some reviews about it, and everyone's saying that this is a new twist in horror. So I'm very interested to see what's going to happen. And I feel like once we leave that movie theater, this sound will never be the same again because, I don't know. I'm really interested to see what that girl is clicking for. Like, I don't know, like, is she clicking because there's, like, monsters coming? Is she clicking because she's summoning a demon? Why the hell is she clicking? Why? Why? So, yeah, I'm interested to see what's gonna happen with that. And I'm gonna go see it, and hopefully you guys go see it, and let me know when you guys go see it, because that's the newest horror movie that's coming out for all of us horror freaks. And yeah, so thank you all for tuning in this week. It means so much to me, and thank you all for the support. And because I got a bunch of great feedback on the Behemoth song I played for you guys last week, I'm going to play, it's a little bit long, but I'm going to play my favorite song from that album. The first song that ever caught my eye or ear on this whole album. So, yeah, thank you all for listening. And we're going to finish off today with O Father, O Satan, O Son from Behemoth's The Satanist. Thank you all. And remember, stay metal.